Paul, the PRA regulates banks, insurers and some other financial institutions from a prudential standpoint. And since 2014, it's also had a secondary objective to facilitate competition. What does this mean and why do we have it?
What it is the secondary competition objective is a requirement on the PRA to, where possible, facilitate effective competition when it's making its policies to further its primary objectives. Why we have it? Effective competition can reduce prices, improve choice, more innovation, all of which foster greater productivity and can lead to greater growth. So the secondary objective is there to put an onus on the PRA to think about competition whenever it's making its policies. And also, looking at prudential regulation through the lens of competition is a very good check on whether the regulations are being applied proportionately and sensibly.
Okay, so competition generates benefits to the economy, but why does the legislation talk about effective competition? What is that?
Well, economists have a concept, a theoretical concept called perfect competition. This assumes there are large numbers of firms producing identical products. There are no frictions, no transactions costs, etc. Effective competition is an attempt to get to a more practical, usable notion of competition. It recognises that there are market failures, that there will be imperfections, but the competition can be effective if these problems are not significant or have been appropriately addressed. For example, may be the case that we don't have large numbers of firms all producing perfect products, but if competition is effective, consumers can still have confidence when they make informed choices. Firms will still be costing in the risks that they're making so that they are confident they can meet their obligations.
Okay, and so the article suggests that the primary and secondary objectives are generally aligned. Can you explain this? Because some people argue that stability and competition are actually in conflict.
Yes, of course. Think of banking. When the PRA acts to improve safety and soundness, they are actually reducing a market failure. As, for example, when they insist that firms have appropriate precautions for the risks on their balance sheet. A consequence of this, for example, is that the implicit subsidy to large banks is removed. This levels the playing field, which helps enhances competition. Similarly, good prudential regulation gives investors confidence when they invest with a small firm that may be a new entrant, again, facilitating effective competition.
Excellent. Paul, thanks very much.